好啦，咁啊上次咧就讲到有两个 case 啊，第一个 case 咧就系咧，咁有五个人咧就绑咗喺条路轨度，嗱呢幅图就话佢企喺度啦，咁篇文咧就话佢绑咗条路轨度啦，另一个咧就绑咗呢一条度啦，系啦，咁咧就你就决定佢哋嘅生死啦，咁呢架车就冲紧去佢哋度，咁你拉唔拉个掣咧？如果你拉咧，佢就会去咗呢条 spur 咧，叫做 spur 就另一条路轨啦，咁就可以救到五个人啦，咁样，咁之后佢话另一个 case 咧。另一個 case 就係咧，馬路上亦都有五個人綁喺度，但係冇呢邊噶啦，即係呢一條路軌係冇噶啦。咁而家你就喺條橋上面啊，你望住呢五個人啦，呢架車就衝緊喺呢五個人度。咁喺條橋上面，你嘅隔離有一個人咧，就一個好肥嘅男人咁樣。佢話咧，如果你擁佢落去咧，佢就會 fall 落咗呢度，咁咧就可以拯救咗呢五個人啦，因為佢會停咗架車咁樣。OK，咁咧上條片咧就係講到呢兩個 cases 啦。好啦，咁啊睇第三同第四啊，今次之后我会拍埋第五啦，咁之后其他你要自己睇噶。第三咧就 in numerical terms, the two situations，头先我讲嘅嗰两个 situations are identical。A strict utilitarian concerned only with the greatest happiness of the greatest number would see no difference. In each case, one person dies to save five.Yet people seem to feel differently about the fat man case. The thought of seizing a random bystander, ignoring his screams, wrestling him to the railing and tumbling him over is too much. Surveys suggest that up to 90% of us would throw the lever in spur, while a similar percentage think the fat man shouldn't be thrown off the bridge. Yet, if asked, people find it hard to give logical reasons for this choice.Assaulting the fat man just feels wrong. Our instincts cry out against it. 第三段话喺数字上咧，头先我讲嘅嗰两个 situations 都系一样嘅 ，identical 即系一样啦。一个 utilitarian 即系一个功利主义者，净系谂利益嘅啫。Concerned only with the greatest happiness, the greatest number， 即系最多人快乐、最开心，即系五够到五个咧就好过一个咁啦。OK， 佢担心佢就即系净系紧张呢样嘢嘅啫 ，happiness 嗰样嘢啦。就覺得冇分別嘅兩個 case， 佢話兩個 case 裏面咧，都係一個人死咗救咗五個人啦。但係 people seem to feel differently about the fat man case， 但係第二個 case 咧話要擁一個人落去親手擁嗰個咧，我哋會覺得有啲唔同嘅嗰、那個，雖然佢都係一個死咗救五個 ，OK 呢個諗法咧 ，seizing 即係捉住 ，OK 捉住一個 bystander 即係一個旁觀者啦，唔理佢喺度嗌啦。OK，wrestling him to the railing 就係橋嘅個橋嗰條邊啦，擁佢 wrestling 即係不停擁佢啊，掙扎擁佢咁啦。And tumbling him over 即係擁佢落去啦。太過火啦 ，is too much 即係太過火啦，係啦。Survey suggest 即係咧，有研究就話咧，有 90% 我哋咧都會 throw the lever in spur。咁乜嘢叫 lever 咧 ？lever 咧就係呢個掣啦。OK， 90% 我哋咧都會 throw the lever in spur， 即係話都會。去呢边嘅得唔得？咁但系咧，同样地啊，90% 嘅人咧都觉得我哋唔应该拱个 fat man 落去嘅。但系如果我哋问系啦，点解啊？点解唔可以咧？点解有啲唔同嘅咧？就我哋好难俾一个 logical reasons for this choice。assaulting 即系攻击啦，即系攻击啦，攻击个 fat man 就系错咯。我哋嘅直觉。大嗌 cry out 即係反對佢係錯啦咁樣。OK， 第四咧就話 nothing intrigues philosophers more than a phenomenon that seems simultaneously self-evident and inexplicable. Thus, ever since the moral philosopher Philippa Foot set out Spurs a thought experiment in 1967, a whole enterprise of trolleyology has unfolded.With trolleyologists generating ever more fiendish variants, Fat Man was developed by the philosopher Judith Jarvis Thompson in 1985. Intrigues 呢個字咧，啲外國人會覺得係一個好好嘅字啊。Intrigues 即係 interest 咁意思，即係冇嘢咧係吸引得過咧一個 phenomenon 一個現象 ，simultaneously 即係同時係好明顯嘅，但係都好難以解釋嘅。即係咩意思呢？即係個 fat man case 好明顯唔應該擁嘅，但係又好似好難解釋咁樣。佢話呢啲咁嘅現象呢係最吸引到 philosophers。咁所以呢就係、是、因為呢樣嘢啦。咁自從呢個叫 moral philosopher 呢個人 set out spur as a thought experiment， 即係頭先以上所講嘅 cases 呢全部都叫 thought experiment， experiment 即係實驗啦，OK，thought 即係思想嘅實驗啦，心理測驗咁啦，即係第一次諗嘅係佢，即係呢個 case 咧，即係呢一個 case 咧，OK 係佢諗嘅，Philippa Foot，OK，自從喺1967年諗咧，咁就勁一大扎 trolleyology 即係電車嗰啲諗嗰啲 thought experiment has unfolded，即係出現咗啦，即係有好多唔同嘅版本啊，都出現咗啦。咁啊，啲 trolleyologists 咧就諗一啲有啲邪惡啲嘅一啲 variants 啊，所以 Fat Man 就係邪惡啲嗰個，就係由呢個諗嘅 Judith Jarvis Thompson 呢個人好出名嘅女人嚟，專諗埋啲奇奇怪怪嘅 thought experiment。